A U.S.-based nuclear energy firm plans to invest in the Philippines. The palace says NuScale Power Corporation may likely invest up to $7.5 billion to provide 430 megawatts to the country by year 2031. According to Marcos, who met with NuScale officials in Washington, D.C., an investment by the company could help address the shortfall in power supply in the Philippines. Meanwhile, Marcos witnessed the signing of a deal between the Ayala Group's Integrated Microelectronics and California-based Zero Motorcycles. The deal, which has an estimated price tag of $65 million, will see the country getting its first electronic motorcycle manufacturing facility. Mass production is expected to begin within the quarter. The Philippines and the U.S. will also deepen cooperation in the agriculture sector. The two countries agreed to set up a ministerial-level team on agricultural cooperation during a meeting between President Marcos and U.S. agriculture officials led by Secretary Thomas Vilsack. In that meeting, Marcos highlighted the country's goal to strengthen agricultural research and biotechnology agenda efforts. He said expanding market access of Philippine agricultural products to the U.S. is also one of government's targets. A stronger alliance, that's the pitch of U.S. President Joe Biden to visiting Philippine counterpart Ferdinand Marcos Jr. during their meeting at the White House. Both leaders agreed there is a need to elevate Manila and Washington's partnership amid geopolitical concerns. Pia Gutierrez reports from Washington.
U.S. President Joe Biden once again affirmed Washington's ironclad commitment to the defense of the Philippines and the South China Sea. He made that assurance during his bilateral meeting with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. at the White House Monday afternoon, where both leaders committed to further strengthen the alliance of the United States and the Philippines. During their meeting, Biden told Marcos Jr. that amid geopolitical challenges, he could not think of a better partner than the Philippines, with whom the United States shares a deep friendship. He also assured of their continued support for the modernization of the Philippine military.
When we met in New York last year, you told me that that a strong alliance has to continue, quote, and this is your phrase, to evolve as we face the challenges of this new century. And we are facing new challenges. And I can't think of any better partner to have than you. I couldn't agree more that we have to, this relationship has to continue to evolve. And the United States also remains ironclad in our commitment to the defense of the Philippines, including the South China Sea. And we're going to continue to support the Philippines' military modernization goals. Mr. President, our countries not only share a strong partnership, we share a deep friendship, one that has been enriched by millions of Filipino Americans and the communities all across the United States of America.
This comes amid shared concerns over China's continued aggression in the West Philippine Sea, the most recent of which is the harassment of a maritime patrol vessel of the Philippines by the Chinese Coast Guard, which caused a near collision at the Yungin Shoal. In the same meeting, Biden also announced that he will send a first-of-its-kind presidential trade and investment mission to the Philippines. Meanwhile, President Marcos Jr., for his part, raised the need for countries to find ways to strengthen alliances and partnerships in the post-pandemic economy. But beyond that, he says there are also issues that places the Philippines in arguably the most complicated geopolitical situation in the world right now. Marcos Jr. says it is but natural for the Philippines to look to its sole treaty partner in the world, the United States, and to further strengthen and redefine its relationship with the U.S., as well as the roles that the countries play in the face of these tensions.
There are also the issues, geopolitical issues, that have made the region where the Philippines is possibly, arguably, the most complicated geopolitical situation in the world right now. And so it is only natural that for the Philippines to look to its sole treaty partner in the world to strengthen and to redefine the relationship that we have and the roles that we play in the face of those rising tensions that we see now around the South China Sea and Asia-Pacific and Indo-Pacific regions.
This is Biden and Marcos Jr.'s second meeting following their bilateral talks September last year at the sidelines of the United Nations General Assembly in New York. Following his meeting in the White House, President Marcos Jr. met with members of the Filipino community at the Ritz-Carlton in Washington, where he thanked the Filipinos in America for working to make a good name to the Philippines with their hard work and sacrifice. He said that his dream for them ultimately is for them to come home to a better Philippines. According to the DFA, there are about 4.4 million Filipinos currently living in the United States. And that's the latest here in Washington, D.C. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines and the U.S. also looking forward to establishing trilateral modes of cooperation with Japan as well as Australia. Meanwhile, an official from Japan's ruling Liberal Democratic Party also affirmed his country's support for the Philippines over the West Philippine Sea issue.